Hello everyone, welcome to astronomy class. In today's class, we will be learning about what is astronomy and how people study and understood astronomy over the years. To begin the class, I would like to ask you all a question. Astro, have you ever wondered upon looking at the sky? Like a bright object called sun in the day and lots of tiny bright dots in the night as the sun goes down. Did you ever think that we are inside a beautiful object called planet which holds all of us together within it? If yes, then let me tell you that we are inside Earth, a beautiful planet with all these bright objects appearing to go around us. So, studying about these objects like sun, moon, stars and many more is called as astronomy, where astro means stars, and one who studies about it are called as astronomers. In this video, we shall learn about how we began to look at the stars. So, let us look back into time then. About 2.5 million years ago, when Earth was still young, it was filled with a lot of trees, animals and birds. And humans were called as cavemen or early men who lived in the forest inside the caves hunting for food and shelter. It is believed that they were too scared of the nature around them until they explored it. They must have believed that there must be someone hiding behind the skies and playing with these objects. It took about many years for the cavemen to understand the celestial nature around them. Objects like sun, moon, and stars would rise and set below the horizon irrespectively. Slowly, as they began to move from one place to another, they started to connect and relate themselves to stars in the night sky. Constellations like the famous Big Bear is known as to identify the North Pole star of the Earth. Soon the navigators would look upon this constellation to understand the direction in which they were traveling. As there were no compass or any kind of instrument to guide them. Many such constellations were looked upon for various purposes like agriculture, calendar, time, seasons, etc. because the constellations vary over a period of 3 months. Let us look at another example. Our one day on Earth is equal to 24 hours on an average. But how did we get to know that? Early humans observed the sun to rise up and set below the horizon in a circular motion, that is, for the day and night. Our day and night is about 12 hours each, which sums up to 24 hours. And that made us believe that objects are rotating, that is, our Earth is rotating, in which we are living. These are very few examples of astronomy in our daily lives. But how did we understand their work? Did they leave a message somewhere on Earth? Yes, they did. Early humans would draw or write what they could see on the rocks or caves, as they did not have tools like pen or a book. They inscribed on the walls or rocks as they observed. Scientists today have found inscriptions and have tried to interpret them. Another interesting thing about the ancient astronomers were that they built monuments like Stonehenge. Stonehenge is a famous ancient architecture built around 3000 BC in England. It is believed that ancient astronomers used these huge rocks placed in circles to understand the motion of sun and study time around us. It could be called as a celestial clock. Although we do not have the complete structure, we are certain about their purpose. Now, let's look at few pioneers in the field of astronomy who worked hard to understand the heavenly bodies. Aristotle, a great scientist and a philosopher, who believed that everything in the sky seems to go around us. Hence, we must be the center of all the celestial objects. Nicholas Copernicus, a famous mathematician and an astronomer who observed the motion of planets carefully for many years, believed that all the heavenly bodies must be going around the bright object called sun. But this theory was opposed as it was against few religious beliefs. Tycho Brahe. a famous astronomer, believed in the work of Copernicus and began to work on it. He continued the observation of many planets in the sky and recorded a lot of data without much of instruments for many years. Sooner, he met Kepler, who also had a keen interest in astronomy and mathematics. But Tycho and Kepler began to share their work on the movement of planets around the Sun. Kepler could soon produce interesting mathematical proof for the solar system that we know today. However, many people and the priests were reluctant to accept his theory, as it was against the religious beliefs, and also there was no instrument which could help us see the objects go around the Sun. It was in 16th century, with the help of telescope, Galileo Galilei looked at the bright object Jupiter in the sky and observed that it had many moons going around it. He quickly noted it and started to observe all the bright planets and provided enough evidence to prove the theory of Kepler. Sooner, we could believe and understand that all objects were going around the Sun in an almost circular path called solar system. The telescope, invented by Hans Lippershey, changed how people could see the heavens above. Today, we have much larger telescopes, which helps us see and observe the stars, which are millions of kilometers far away from us. And we believe that there could be many Earth-like planets going around the stars in the sky. I'm sure this session would have inspired you to look at the sky above us. Thank you all for watching this session.